I've seen fire and I've seen rain. I always thought I'd see you again.
You know, we did an orchestra. When we were first starting to do orchestral work, we worked with the Pittsburgh Symphony in their pops version, and Marvin Hamlisch was the conductor, and he was great. He had a huge amount of energy and did a great job. But he thought it would be a good idea to do, he wrote something for Fire and Rain, which was a music to take bows by, sort of. It was the last song in the set, and we were supposed to come out and take bows. And meanwhile, he had this sort of like, a loop that the orchestra was playing of Fire and Rain. It was really just amazingly Atlantic City, sort of Vegas kind of treatment of the song, really antithetical to it. The only other thing that bore any resemblance to that or challenged it in terms of weird was the first time I ever performed it on television was in, you know, like 1970 in England at a show called Top of the Pops, which ran forever and ever, terrible, but a fixture of English television, a BBC show. And they had dancers that were basically on contract, so dancers were gonna come out and dance. And the dancing behind Fire and Rain, just not to be believed. Not to be believed. Essentially go-go dancers with Fire and Rain. And sort of the fans with cheap special effect flames and, oh man. Not to be believed. Just right. Sort of, you know, they were obviously having a sort of tiff anyway, the two people in the makeup room there, the Today Show at 5 o'clock in the morning, whatever the god-hot, ungodly hour it was. Why can't they just paint hair on? I don't understand why. No, you should have done that, taken me back in time.